Now, Richard, tell me, when you go to work at the BBC in London, where do you park your car?
Well, Jeremy, I park it in the car park at the BBC, underground, yeah, where everybody else parks. Mm-hmm. That's, where do you park?
I park in the underground car, yeah, park. It's a bit of a walk, but that's what you're
that's
supposed
where you
to
park.
Do.
Yeah.
Now, there is a loading bay just outside our office, which is a lot more convenient, but obviously there's no parking there. Now, I took a photograph in this loading bay this week, OK? Here it is. Now, we may recognise this car if we watch The Apprentice. It belongs to Lord Sir Sugar.
Yeah, but to be fair, his chauffeur was probably loading him into the building at the time.
Exactly.
So he could be in the loading
Technically,
bay.
This was a delivery, so that's yes. fine. More worrying is this. OK, if we zoom in. Now, right there, there's a little Fiat Panda parked blocking the door and the honest working men whose job is to deliver things to the BBC. Hmm. And I'm wondering, Hammond, who has a little black Fiat Panda?
I don't know. At the BBC?
Does David Attenborough? No, he doesn't.
Paxman. Moving on.
Fiat Panda. We looked at it earlier. Okay. This is officially the slowest accelerating car money can buy. 0 to 60 in 20 seconds.
That is very slow.
It's true fact, but it's £8,500
it's
for
fabulous.
That. And really good, it's four-wheel drive, which really annoys environmentalists.
What did you say, it was a donkey?
It's a donkey, it's a little mule, and it really does annoy the eco-mentalists. Weird beards are good, four-wheel drive, but then, oh yeah, so on that basis,
oh,
it
yeah.
is a cool car.
Very yeah, it
cool
is, a very car. Cool car.
James owns one of those.
James May owns one of these. What's he doing up?
They're the rules. You've taken it to the limit, but they are the rules.
You can't get much less cool than that. Our first task was to test out each other's cars. And we began with the Panda's brilliant passenger entry system.
Have you two never seen The Great Escape? I mean, it's perfectly straightforward. Look, what is pulley? You lie on this, OK?
And Britney Spears is going to do that, yeah?
This is ideal, really, for people who used to be miners.
I thought you had sniffed thinners making that.
James offered to join me in the back.
Here he comes.
It's an ingenious solution to a problem that should never have existed in the first place.
Next, I introduced Hammond to the in-car communications.
There's an intercom system, and it's hands-free. So if you put that thing round your neck, it's like a one-man band thing, so it's legal.
This isn't the most elegant sleeve.
I have literally thought of everything.
Right, I'm pulling away. Hold on tight.
Give it to me.
You'll note as you swing around, it doesn't have quite that same responsiveness.
Running out of runway. Oh, no. I'm sorry. I'm on the field a bit.
You see, the flex takes some of the jolting out of it.
What have you done? You've gone over a runway light, you blithering idiot!
Yeah, well, it's you made the car a mile long. It's hardly my fault.
While Hammond unwrapped his car, James and I turned our attention to his Fiat Panda.
I bought it from an English family who had bought a house in Tuscany. And this little Pepe. Pepe the Panda, and they loved it.
Do you know, I know everything about this family. This has been used for picking their friends up from Pisa Airport.
Oh, undoubtedly.
And their friends are the editor of The Guardian.
Yes.
Tony Blair.
Sherry Blair.
Sting. Alan Yentob.
Yes.
Every single lightweight socialist in Britain has been in this car.
I bet they made their own olive oil as well.
Oh, no, we're socialists, really. As they are sitting with their Prosecco, we really care. We're raising awareness. Raising awareness means I'm doing absolutely nothing at all. I bet they had a little man in the village.
As the pet shop boy ranted on.
There's a chap here, George Howard, he's 14 years old. He says his father takes him to school in a 1992 white Fiat Panda.
Oh, no, that's cruel. That's not right.
He actually says God has not answered my request for help, no matter how much I ask him. He says, I am so desperate, I even tried sacrificing a small goat.
See, it's having an effect already. No, this is serious. This has a deep sociological effect. It's a short trip from being dropped off in a rubbish car at school to Well, they'll be kicking down the door of your bedsit and finding a head in your fridge.
There will be. So listen, kids, you know, I know there's a lot of discussion in the newspapers and on TV about the school run, what it should be done in. It's what type of car. That's what matters. If you're ashamed by your parents' car, then write to us and we'll shame them. So George Howard of, where's he from? The internet. George Howard from the internet, Mr. and Mrs. Howard, sell the Panda.
It doesn't have to be expensive or a Ferrari, just not rubbish and embarrassing.
Exactly.
We'll have a nice little room as always.
What sort of a moron would buy a car as dreadful and as dreary as a Fiat Panda? You'd have to be a woolly-headed oaf with a wardrobe full of stupid stripy jumpers and idiotic floral shirts, and at night you drone on and on in front of your friends about gravity and maths and steam locomotives, and then you'd explain that pencil sharpeners are interesting.
But if it's the truly affordable and dependable people's champion you're looking for, I could have saved you all that trouble and just taken you here.
It all comes together in this. It's a perfectly normal car. It's also a bit of an off-roader. The ghosts of the Jeep and the rally cars and the all-wheel drive supercars, there's a little bit of them in this. It is... ta-da! The original Fiat Panda 4x4. I hope you're not disappointed. Because you shouldn't be.
It definitely qualifies as a people's car. It will take a family. Just, it's cheap to run and easy to maintain. It's as much car as it needs to be, and no more.
Of which, how are the electric windows in your Porsche Boxster?
Fine.
Still broken?
No, they work. I'm not always in it when they work.
Yeah, he's normally... in bed when they work.
Well, maybe, but my other car, the Fiat Panda, I think I'm right in saying, what's funny about it?
No, you couldn't be more right. He does have a Fiat Panda, and you're right, James, it was in the top 10 with all the Skodas. What people are saying here is that it was better than they thought it was going to be.
Yes.
That was just like buying a ton of manure. It doesn't smell that bad, actually.
To be honest, I am quite surprised by it because it's fun to drive, it's well made, it's economical, it looks good.
It says all of that in the magazine bump, but it also says that people claimed it was predictably slow. Which it is, be
honest. Why don't you tell the ladies and gentlemen what happened when we all met up the other day to go on a shoot, met at the hotel, we had to go to location, you turned up in your... I had an Aston that day and you had a 911.
Yeah.
Well, all right, but in fairness, I had only picked it up that morning and it only had 8 miles on the clock and I didn't know what all the knobs and things did yet.
What do you mean? There's only 2 knobs in it. Well, 3 if you count the one who bought it. It's a simple car.
Anyway, I said, look, I haven't got a map. Can I just follow you? And they said, yes, yes, of course you can. Come on, off we go. And they went off at 120 miles an hour.
You should have bought a faster car, then you could have kept up.
You used it as an excuse last night to fondle my leg.
Rubbish,
you
rubbish.
Did.
I tell you, he said, oh, I'll give you a lift to the pub. We got into a Fiat Panda, he kept saying, stop touching me. You can't not touch someone.
No.
It's like sharing a bath with somebody.
He's got, get on the back of my horse, but don't touch me.
He exploited the diminutive size of my Panda to sit there going, oh, I'm terribly sorry. And it really is. I mean, you get 4 doors, you get electric front windows, you get a radio, you get power steering, you get 2 airbags, you get alloy wheels, and you get anti-lock brakes.
This is looking good for Italy. The Panda's honest, it's cheap, it's very roomy. What else do we know about the Italians? Oh yes, they all think they're Ayrton Senna.
Now, this Panda is not fast. 0 to 60 takes 14 seconds, which is long enough to knock up a decent penne al pesto. And the top speed is 96 miles per hour. But by the time you get there, Venice will have sunk.
So, you just have to drive like an Italian. Blow the horn, wave your arms around, and thrash it.
I quite like this 1.2 engine. It's sort of feisty and eager. makes a great deal of fuss without really achieving very much. A bit like the Italian government, really. I think Fiat has got this small, cheap car, remember, pretty much spot on. I mean, it's got the right size, it's definitely the right price, it's got the right amount of space, it's got the right amount of kit. But for an Italian car, there's still something that bothers me. Well, that's not right. I mean, I've had this thing nearly a week and nothing's fallen off and everything still works. I mean, who the hell do the Italians think they are anyway? The Germans?
Now, are there any mothers here? Yes? Well, Fiat has decided you need patronising. So, they've come up with a limited edition version of the Panda. We've got a picture of it here.
Why is it for mothers?
Because it's called the Panda Mammy. Taking, and they've given it an orange interior and a purple exterior to match Ivarica's veins.
This is and a really big boot that it's embarrassed about. Yeah.
And its airbags are 2 feet lower down on a normal model. What are they going to do next to Fiat recently divorced father? The sat-nav that only goes to the zoo.
That's a good idea, actually, because I've got a Fiat Panda and I've also got a very young nephew and a young niece, so they could bring out the Panda unsuitable uncle, which has just sort of got a very sharp kitchen knife left lying around.
Anyway, time for an ambitious finale. Will the salesman rumble our Top Gear comparison test as we bring on the Fiat Panda?
Yeah, that's a Panda. I think that is actually the basic active Panda. That's quite interesting because I think the Panda's slightly better equipped. You do get electric windows, you do get power steering as standard, you do get central locking. It's got two airbags as well because it's got one for the passenger. And it's about £200 cheaper, £6,300.
Right, by now he really does think I'm barking, so it's back to the dealership. And there you go, one completed road test, one unsuspecting dealer, but only one verdict.
I think I like the Panda more, though, if I'm really honest.
When I arrived, the track was enveloped in typical British autumnalness.
Right, here we go. Top Gear test track, my patch for the day. Now, I've been very, very insistent with the office. I don't want to find some look-at-me two-door Italian supercar with a 250 miles per hour speedo and a £250,000 price tag or any of that sort of rubbish. I want to drive something more like, well, to be honest, some... Oh, cock. Surely not.
Fiat Panda, yeah, the boxy one that Gisaro designed.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Whenever I walked past one of those with a group of friends, he always picked it up and turned it round, so people would...
Yes.
You could just kiss ever see it. I was going, no, how's that happened?
In the same way that... It's not actually about how much power you have. It's about how much power you can use. And in this, you can use pretty much all of it, all of the time.
Look. I like sitting 5 millimetres above the road in a 500-horsepower supercar as much as anybody else.
Whee!
But skinny tyres and a roly-poly body, that's fun.
The lack of grip means that more of the time you're driving this car at the edge, even at quite normal speeds, and it's at the edge where things become absolutely tremendous. Ooh, bit of spiralling.
And as for that engine, well, it may be tiny, but it packs a punch. And it sounds just brilliant.
Oh, I love that thrumming noise. It's such a happy sound. It's a bit like a dog running around with a frisbee in its mouth, going, come on, come on, come on, come on. Throw the frisbee, throw the frisbee.
And the cost of this bundle of fun? Around £11,000. Half the price of the Corsa. However, there is a potential problem with a small-engined car. Here's the stick, taking the Panda from naught to 70 and back to naught again.
He did that, according to the wheel-o-distance, in 305 metres. But the big question is, how does a small engine car like this cope when it's weighed down with people? Now, if it's just the stick, then it makes no odds, as you can see quite clearly. But if it's normal members of the public, then I think we may have a problem. You see, according to the newspapers, more than a quarter of adults are now obese. And in just a few years' time, over 50% of the population will be absolutely enormous. So, what could a typical family of the future do to this car's performance? Right, so with just the Stig, it was 305 metres. With our family on board, it took an extra 177 metres, more than half as much again. So, if you buy this car, you might want to think about going easy on the pasties. But trust me, it's worth it. James Hunt was once famously asked what was the best car he'd ever driven, and the answer was not a Ferrari or a Porsche or any supercar. It was his old Austin A35 van, which had virtually no power and very, very skinny tyres. In other words, exactly the same qualities you get with the Panda. And if that's good enough for James Hunt, I rest my case. Thank you, and goodbye.